Sai Ram, with pranams at the lotus feet of our Bhagavan, brothers and sisters, I am so happy to be amongst you this morning after long gap. We met probably in the month of September 23rd, if I am right. The last talk was on September 23rd, and we are meeting now. Of course, in between, we had Dasara celebrations and birthday celebrations, and during that period, the talks were cancelled. So, it is a thing beyond my control, because talks were cancelled because of the those two festivals. And later, I had certain engagements. I sincerely let you know how I am engaging myself these days. I am happy to say that, because I know that you are all basically devotees of Bhagavan. Ever since the Swami left his physical body, devotees world over are in a dilemma, or in a dilemma, if I am to say that, are in a confused state. Because we live in a small family like this, many of us are not aware what is going on around. When once you step out of this campus, we will understand there is a lot of confusion in the minds of devotees. Why? Because the image is tarnished by many people, like media and other personnel, for their own selfish reasons and self-interest. The image is tarnished. People have so many doubts. And I cannot say, please don't doubt. I cannot say, never put forward your doubts. Because these are the days of free expression. People of my age are here. My straight question to them is this: can we ask our grandchild to keep quiet? When the grandchild starts asking why, can you say shut up? Can you say that? In our days, we knew how to keep our mouth shut. Therefore, we were trained in that atmosphere. Therefore, even today, we have no guts to ask. We lost that courage. But today, children won't keep quiet. If you ask them, wear blue shirt, why? Come along with me, we have got dinner tonight with Anil Kumar. No. I have my friends visiting, man. Sorry, Dad. They'll tell you right on the face. If you are successful to make your grandchildren go along your way, it's an open challenge. You will fail. And we should have courage to accept that we have failed. Because children of today are different. They want to know why. Let's go to the temple, why? Oh, don't eat tonight because today is fasting, why? I don't know why I should fast. How can I tell him to fast? So these are the questions people question. These are the days of investigation, inquiry, exploration, reasoning and rationale. By saying that I am not prepared to answer the questions, don't doubt anything, that is all outdated, archaic procedure. Therefore, my first task I have addressed myself is to answer the questions of these people to the best of my ability. Having been here in Prashantra, I am working in his institutions for the last 25 years, if I fail to answer, who else will answer? Therefore, I ventured, took the risk, and started answering questions of these doubting Thomases world over. Confusion. The second, some of the devotees, some I am not saying all, are after a procedure to go anywhere, anytime for anything. Something like omnibus. Go anywhere, anybody, for anything, anytime. Since Swami is not physically available, I want to get my daughter married without dowry. So there is another Swamiji there, let me go to him. And I want to get my son married with dowry, as maximum as possible. So there is another Swamiji, let me go there. To avoid dowry, this Swami. To get more dowry, another Swami. This has become the trend among many people, to run after people, to run after Swamijis like this. This is one category. I have taken up this job voluntarily, imposing on myself. How to prevent this? How to see that they don't jump out of the fence? Just as in politics, they go on changing parties. There are people, this is spiritual politics or political spirituality. You may call it anyway. How to stop it? That is the task I have addressed myself. One thing is to clarify the doubts. The second, to prevent people jumping out of the fence. And the third thing is, believe me, I think you'll agree with me, nowhere in the world, in no spiritual organization, you find maximum number of dedicated, committed, devoted people who work voluntarily, without expecting anything. Disciplined, devoted people, duty-minded, as in such an organization. Nowhere you find like that group. Nowhere. It's open thing. In many of the organizations, we find people paid for it. We find some TV channels where people pay for their telecasts. Many people know that. Therefore, without propaganda, without publicity, without any financial deal, selflessly, with the spirit of duty, discipline and love, if there is any organization having workers with these qualities, it is Sri Satya Sai Service Organization. Nowhere. It's open thing. Now what's happening is, some of these people, disciplined people, are attracted by spiritual leaders outside. Because they'll sincerely work. There are many gurus. If some of our people go there, they'll work honestly, diligently, doing seva, very good. So we have got our own weakness to jump out of the fence and their own selfish interest to attract this group. Let me not mention, I have got all the statistics with me. It's not my imagination. It is not a fiction. It is a reality. This I should prevent. And nextly, we should also enlist youngsters, as many as possible, and draw them into our fold, younger generation. We see there is a stipulated period to be in office everywhere. Obama, President, America, for instance, now doing his second term, because he had to be sworn in next month. After that, he cannot contest for the third term. He cannot. Though people want him, he cannot, because Constitution says that one cannot contest for more than two times.
with the result people don't rot. There may be better choices, why not? Therefore, we should have clear-cut procedure to enroll youngsters who are ready to prepare to shoulder the responsibility of the organization. Sach Sai Baba is in the forefront in this matter. He is the greatest, or rather I should say highest champion for the cause of youngsters. How do you say? Those who have been here are listening to Swami, are exposed to Swami right from 1970s till late 1980s. Even before, right from 60s. If we just take an account of the people who addressed Purnachandra Auditorium, who spoke in the august presence of Bhagwan Sri Sat Sai Baba, happened to be scholars of the day, great pandits, renowned. Since you do not know their names, I don't want to exhibit my scholarship as a sort of my memory to tell you who they are, but ready to quote you a number of names. Great scholars of the day. Slowly, slowly what Swami did was, he started giving chances to students, lecturers. Ever since they have come to the forefront, they are the pioneers. Today, most of the speakers are students and staff members from Sat Sai University. Meaning, Swami already started recruiting youngsters into the Sai fold. He already started it. Then if you take the statistics here, in every wing of the organization, be that trust or Radio Sai or hospital or university, anywhere, stores, there are many, many youngsters, old students working here, alumni, former students of the university. Swami already recruited them here in all the wings of the organization. So let us take the example of Sai and see that we draw youngsters into our fold. Then how to go about it? Shall we say goodbye to all seniors now? Shall we say that seniors, thank you, no more your services are needed? That is not spiritual way. Whenever a vice chancellor retires, because I am the proof, whenever a vice chancellor of the university retires, Swami mentions necessarily in his divine discourse, you can verify Sanasardi. What does he say every time? As per government rules, so and so is retiring as the vice chancellor of our university, as per government rules and requirements, but he is not going anywhere. He will continue to stay with us. He will cooperate. He will guide the incoming man. He will guide the man who is to be inducted as the new vice chancellor today. And they will work hand in hand like brothers. That's what Baba said. It is not taking the position by force. He wants all the seniors to guide them. He wants all seniors to treat youngsters as their brothers. He wants youngsters to take their advice. And he expects seniors to guide them. This is a spiritual organization. This is not a political organization where one party comes to the rule and says goodbye to the other party. This is not a government where, when the government change, all the secretaries are transferred, some other secretaries are appointed in their place. It is not government organization. It is not a political organization.
This is a spiritual organization.
Why? We need people of all the three generations, the past, present and the future. All of us work together,
like an incessant flow of a river. That is the task I have taken up myself. Encourage youngsters, give them. They'll do very, very well.
To give one example, just I gave an idea long back, about 15 years or so. An idea. Other boys, you're talking very well. I will appreciate if you take your subject and correlate with Baba's message. Correlate with Baba's message. And I gave 2 to 3 talks as a sample dose. They liked it very much. And I said, next week is your chance. Professor, I justify my position being absent-minded. I forgot that it was the student's turn, but I came fully prepared with my talk. I don't go anywhere and give a talk, speak as I like. To speak as one likes is utter disrespect to his audience. We should not do it as a teacher or a speaker. Better you go on leave and lie down on bed. You are accountable, you are credible. People come here expecting something useful from you. You cannot simply brag like that. So when I was about to climb, one boy came. Sir, today is our turn, he said. Oh, good. I'm sorry, come on, you take up. What is your subject? He said, sir, I'll speak on computers and Baba. Computers and Baba. I was dumbfounded. He's an M.Tech boy. And his name is Sri Ram. He goes all around the world today. May have breakfast in Moscow and lunch in New York, something like that. Well, very intelligent boy. Won so many gold medals right from the school level. All right, come on, do it, I said. Please believe me, my friends. He has done exceedingly well, a record performance. Computers and Baba. Well, I could not control my joy, because every teacher expects his students to excel. Every parent expects his children to excel them. Here is my boy who excelled his computers and Baba. Wow. Wow. I was thinking about it all around the day. In the evening I came to the mandir and Swami sat there. Some music program was going on. He called me. What happened this morning? He said. I said, Swami, this morning what happened was, I thought it is my turn and I got ready with my talk. But a boy comes to me and tells me that it is his turn to speak. Then what happened? He gave wonderful talk, Swami. What is the topic? Computers and Baba, huh? Computers, Baba? Yen cheppinadu, what did he say? Swami, computer, all those science above my head. I am a student of biology who completed his studies 40 years ago, outdated. I don't know the computers. If I press one, the existing matter also will vanish. So I don't know, Swami. He spoke very well. All boys appreciated it. It seems all latest interview. Then he started telling everybody that, see my boys, they can speak on any topic. See, he spoke this morning, computers and Baba, see that. He was very proud of him. And then he said, who is he? Swami, Sri Ram. I see. Then what is your opinion about it? Swami, the boy did much better than what I would have done for myself. With the preparation I have had, with adequate preparation I came. But that boy did much exceedingly well. He was very happy, patted him on the back. And he said loudly, Sri Ram, where are you? That boy came from a distance. Mitra is for him, a diamond ring had fit in his finger. There are claps all over. This is not a simple incident. This is not a simple miracle or an experience. This is an event that has a message behind it, that the modern generation can do much better than the earlier generations. With their investigative scientific mind, they can explain our scriptures much better than what we would have done for ourselves. So it's time that we prepare youngsters along these lines, introduce them in different wings, in different fields, teach them. I give my experience. There in the university, they undertaken one project, 1 week, talks on Ramayana. One to speak on one character. Rama one day, Sita one day, like that. My turn came. I said, sir, what are you going to speak? Give me any topic, no problem. Okay. Just that morning when I am supposed to speak, what I did was, I kept 4 chairs on the dais. According to them, I am supposed to speak, but they find 4 chairs. Boys spoke there. 1 or 2 of them are lecturers now. They sat there. Then what I did was, I did some homework before. I selected these 4 boys. I spoke to them. Baba's interpretation of Ramayana is different from conventional Ramayana. It is not a storytelling. Swami explains Ramayana with a meaning, with a relevance and application to the modern generation. Yes, it is not simply a story. It conveys indirectly how we should conduct ourselves. It has a message that will set guidelines for our lifeline. I told them what these points are. I coached them, wrote down on a paper, just points, something like bullets in computer language, 1, 2, 3 like that. The fellows are very intelligent. If we just tell him, tada, they can do it. They have prepared very well. That morning, all the 4 fellows participated. One started explaining argument between Sita and Rama, as explained by Baba. Another boy started explaining the argument between Rama and Bharata as put by Bhagavan Sri Satsai Baba. Another boy, the kind of dialogue between Rama and Vali as explained by Satsai Baba. All these points are wrote. I tell you, that's one of the memorable days of my stay in the university. Therefore, it is our fault to have not directed them properly. It is our fault for not allowing them to get into our shoes. Whereas at home, we distribute our properties, we want them to take care of those things, but here, we are not ready to distribute, we are not ready to delegate, we are not ready to share the responsibility. Very unfortunate. Baba tells us, you are not the body, you are not the mind, you are not the intellect. But I tell Baba, Swami, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, correct, but I am the position. I am the position, therefore I don't want to leave it. That is the situation. So my objective is to recruit youngsters, give them kind of energy, so they are ready to shoulder the responsibilities. As Baba has done here. It's not anything new that Anil Kumar has undertaken. No, he has done already. Someone were asking me, why did not Baba ask some who are very seniors to retire? Why? Somebody asked me. I gave him the answer. Swami is beyond age. Even 70 years man is a boy in front of him. That's all. He told Jogarao in front of everybody. Jogarao was 80 at that time. A boy come here, he said. All of us were wondering, what, 80 years boy? And then he laughed and said, all are boys to me, all are my children. So he cannot tell anybody, you step down, you come here, because all are his children. It is for me to step down because of love for him. It is for me to give a place to somebody because of my love for him. Love means not attachment. Love means he is not holding on to position. Love means he is not preventing anybody to step into our shoe. Love is not to be antagonistic to the incumbent. Love is not withdrawal. Because I am not there in position, I withdraw. It's not love. Love is sacrifice. Love is preparedness. Love is share. Love is delegating powers. Love is the one that makes other person ready to take your responsibility. Such a Sai is not only God, he has got a mission. He has got an organization which has to run very well in future. Bhagavan has been commenting long back that if this organization would long last for 500 years at least, should we not get prepared for such a declaration? It is only possible when we get the second line of leadership ready, ready. My friends, to sum up, the task I have taken upon myself is to clear the doubts of everybody. And the second task is to see that nobody would leave the organization, that others would not draw them. Third, to get the second line of leadership ready. For to give a new direction to the organization. The way how my father, my parents, grandparents lived is different from my parents' life. We had the charcoal, the firewood, cooking in those days. They are replaced by gas stove, I believe. And they may have some ovens or something tomorrow. I cannot have, let me have firewood back again. People will laugh at you. Days have changed. Methods have changed. We should also be alert to this. How to present Baba to the present generation? You cannot present Baba basing on your experiences. There are some people who go on saying that Baba has given me a ring. So what? This is my question. So what? What does it mean to me? And some people also say, Swami called for an interview and said this. He has not called me for an interview. If he called for an interview, it is your problem. It is your problem. It's not my problem. And then where is the guarantee that he said these words? My grandson will ask me. If I tell him, alright, Baba told me all this, stop that story. They won't believe that. Therefore, to present Baba today should be different from the past. When Bhagwan is there, yes, you speak anything. In the name of Swami, they will tolerate you. Here, they will react, retaliate, retort, doubt, pull your collar. They will ask all the details. Yes. Therefore, my friends, how to present Swami to the present generation, particularly with reference to the period we are in, I mean withdrawal of Bhagavan from his physical body, how to present him? My humble opinion is, less and less we speak of our personal experiences, better and better it is. Because they don't understand. They can't believe. There are many seniors here. Would you believe yourself that these things happened at one time? I'm not able to believe. When I think of all the conversations, all the miracles I witnessed, the dialogues I had, I'm not able to believe them today true to be true. Because that has gone into the history. As individuals, we are not able to believe them to have happened in our life. then how do you convince others? Impossible. Because what all that happened in those days, that what we have witnessed, that's all history. And to the present generation, it would look like mystery. They were all experiences. Today, those who have not been exposed to Swami, they become questionable. We consider them as rewards, boons, gifts of grace. Today, they have become expressions which are doubtful in the minds of the youngsters. Therefore, we need to bring a change, a paradigm shift in our presentation. We don't need any hero to teach us. We don't need anybody to tell us. Take Bhagavan Baba himself. How about his talks till 70s? How about his talks from 70 to 90? How are his talks from 90 onwards? Till 90s or late 80s, all his talks are full of stories and parables. Full of stories, anecdotes, stories, songs, jokes, fun and frolic. Later from 90s onwards, he was speaking on non-dualism, Advaita. No more stories, no more anecdotes. Is not anything like sugar-coated tablets. Tablets straight away. Mother tincture. Not homeo pills mixed there. High potency. Advaita is highest potency in spirituality that humanity can ever think of for ages to come. Swami started speaking on Advaita from 90 onwards. You can refer any of his talks. And we also find Swami addressing himself to the situation. The way how he talks to school children, to university students, doctors, engineers, scientists who work there in Baba Atomic Research Center, members of the parliament there in Gyan Bhavan, Delhi, that is different. He doesn't speak in the same way as he speaks elsewhere. No. I know Swami talking there at Chennai. That meeting was attended by 4 governors, 5 top ministers, cabinet ministers. He spoke on the role of government, how the government should be. The meeting ended with national anthem, not Harati. Not Mangala Harati. It ended with national anthem. That is such a Sai Baba. That is such Sai Baba. He is not dogmatic. He is not fanatic. While we are lunatics. Unfortunate. Very unfortunate. He knows how to mold himself. Another example. He had been to Baha'i Center there in New Delhi. There in Baha'i Center, each man started speaking on one religion. You know where Baba sat? He sat among the audience. He was listening to their talks, like all of us. That is such a Sai Baba. Unlike some of us who say, when Swami is God, why should they talk like that? Is that the place where Swami should sit? Can't they speak about Swami? Are that's all Swami's problem, not your problem. That is Sai way. Because always lead to only Sai way. Therefore he could sit there and listen to every talk, every presentation, sitting among the audience. Those presentations. That spirit we have to develop. That balanced state of mind we should develop. That equanimous mind that we should develop. I am highlighting these points because the topic of the day happens to be tasks now. That is the topic I purposefully announced. Task now. What is the task now? My task now is not to boast myself, telling you how close I was with Swami. Are you were and you are not. In your case, your intimacy is already a past tense. How about us then? Keep it yourself. Pocket it. Therefore, my friends, the way how we look at Swami today should be universal, should be cosmic, should be general, should be message-oriented. For which purpose Swami has come down in human form? He even remarked, all the experiences and the gifts of grace that conferred upon you are only bait to draw you closer to me. They are just visiting cards to get you into the mansion of my divinity. That's what he said. But we say, that bait is enough for me. That card is enough for me. Who can help us for 100 lives to come? Therefore, my friends, a kind of change is necessary in our activities, in our presentations. Any longer they should not be any longer repetitive, monotonous, laborious, boring. It cannot be like that. Simple example, if you are to speak in a church, if you are to speak at a gathering of Christians, if you go on hammering people about your own experiences, saying that Baba is God and all that, out of etiquette and good manners they may sit, or else they would quit. If you study Bible, quote freely, authentically, with all credibility, relate it with Bhagavan's message, yes, you'll be successful. This is the time to do it. It's not one-way traffic. Baba is an example. I saw him in action while he was talking to a bishop. He did not speak on Rama and Krishna. He did not speak on Bhagavad Gita. That bishop cannot say who Krishna is. I don't think that he would be able to pronounce Krishna. He did not speak anything of himself. Baba went on speaking about the Holy Bible, my friends, I am the witness. Holy Bible. He started giving interpretation of biblical anecdotes, biblical messages, biblical dicta, and started giving version, interpretation in a novel way that thrilled the bishop himself. Ultimately, he fell at his feet. That is such Sai Baba. Therefore, I personally feel that there should be a change in our presentations, in our activities, with a difference from the past, so that we will be more acceptable to the general public. The leadership also should recognize one thing. Till now I say, you do that. They did it because of Swami. Today if I say, if you do that, they say, why? Why not you do it? In the past, when they said these things are expected of you as devotees, they heard because of Swami. Today if I tell these are things that you expected of you as a devotee, one youngster will come and ask, they are applicable to you also. If I say, come on, Narayan Seva, free food, yes, feeding the poor, should be done all over the world as head. Some of them will say, we can't get hundreds in countries like US, Germany, Japan. Poor feeding will have poor performance in those countries. It is not applicable here. Meaning, we have to change according to the place. Yesterday somebody asked me, he is from Argentina. Mr. Anil Kumar, in our schools, boys and girls study together. Is it permissible? Or should we segregate? I told them, be a Roman when you are in Rome. You cannot apply Indian principles to Argentina. Argentina lost to India. No. So what you have been following, come on. Simple example, Baba. It was a conference of doctors, international. They are all permitted to enter into the auditorium, sit on the chairs while Swami was there with shoe and socks. They were all there with shoes and socks. Swami did not say, leave your slippers outside, come here, I am God. He did not say. We demons would say it. God will never say. He will never come down to the level of slippers. And he will never slap. He just, that's Western style. They go to church with shoes on. Nothing wrong there. So he just sat there. They were quite normal. The suits and socks and all. Therefore, my friends, I gave him advice, come on, do it in according to the law of the land. I cannot apply this here, I cannot apply this over there. Go to the fundamental principles, go to the fundamental laws, go to the core of his message, the center of his divinity. Don't fight on peripheral matters, on issues like this. It's not like that. Somebody says, shall we give Harati or not? I said, in some countries, you cannot give arati, light the camphor, because police people will stop their van there and collect you. Because they think some fire accident there. So don't give arati. By not giving arati, you are not becoming an atheist or a non-devotee. Or by giving arati, you cannot say you are a saint or highest level of devotee. Both are meaningless. What is the meaning of arati? At the end of arati, nothing remains. Everything gets exhausted, the whole camphor. The meaning of arati is, I have offered myself unto you, my Lord. Now I am empty. Oh God, I am nobody. I have emptied myself. I am nobody, Swami. I have offered you. That is arati. Not bringing bundles of camphor and put it on the face of the other man until his face burns. I don't know. Therefore, a new direction is necessary. A new approach is necessary. We should work with a vision in Sai Mission. We should work with a vision in Sai Mission. Many people may not agree with you, because some are determined to live in the old style. But I was talking to somebody. I am a lonely fighter. Doesn't matter, I will continue in my way. The other man said, why do you say you are a lonely fighter? You are a lovely fighter, he said. I have not said it as an act of fishing for compliments. I live for that. Having spent all my life for the organization for 40 years, at the cost of my family conveniences and family time, I cannot keep quiet when things go wrong. I cannot shut my mouth when some ideas come to me like that. Be a source of displeasure to somebody, I don't mind. I will express myself freely. Therefore, there should be some change in our leadership. not demand, not command, but plead, but request. Win the love of the people rather by circular. Those days are gone. Therefore, my friends, more and more of value, more and more of respect to the feelings of the devotees today is more important than leadership. I think you understand me. We the devotees should openly submit that's what we want. That's how things should go. This is what Swami said. According to that, things should happen like this. We should be able to say that. Therefore, there should be a change. All people have been observing Swami till today. They all look at Swami only. And today, they look at me as an office bearer, how I am. I cannot say attend bhajans regularly, being absent for myself. Never attend bhajans. I cannot tell everybody service is important when I don't attend service activities. Because people watch me. Therefore, credibility and accountability of all of us is more important today than ever before. Seeing Swami, they are lost, that's all. Today, they see you, how we are, how determined we are, how committed we are, how dedicated we are, how disciplined we are, how selfless we are. They are going to look at Swami through the spectrum of a devotee. In other words, the life today is related to Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam consists of the experiences of all devotees. All Bhagavatam is a text of the experiences of devotees. Meaning, we should learn from the devotees. The devotees project themselves in the book for us to know and learn how to be a devotee. What his responsibilities are. Swami mentions in one of his discourse the story of Mansur. Mansur declared in the court of the king, there is God, Anal Haq. God is great. Glory unto God, Anal Haq, he said. King felt very bad. How can you say glory? You should say glory to the king, not glory to God. He imprisoned him. Still, Mansur said, Anal Haq, he is great. God is great. Then king ordered him to chop off his legs and hands. Still he went on saying, Anal Haq, God is great. Finally, the king ordered that he should be hanged. And he was hanged. The body is reduced to ashes. With the blowing wind, the ashes of Mansur started repeating, Anal Haq, God is great, God is great. That is the quality of a devotee. That is the quality of a devotee. Therefore, devotees are most important today. The kind of sacrifice they lead, they are prepared to, the sort of disciplined life they have, the spirit of contentment, and the guts to speak, the courage to speak, when things go wrong. Because at one time Swami said, the one who has done a mistake is not the only fellow who is guilty. The one who accepts that, who doesn't condemn, is equally guilty. The one who prompted him to commit the mistake is equally guilty. Therefore, to be silent or they play the role of a spectator without correcting when things go wrong, we are guilty. We are the sinners. My friends, we devotees, we are all the custodians of Sai treasure. We are all the custodians of Sai treasure. We have to preserve it. We have to safeguard it. We have to improve upon it. We have to develop interest and the interest of Sai treasure. We have greater role to perform today than ever before. Keeping these ideas in my view, I have been going around the world, going around different places, talking about our role today. Post Samadhi days, how we should be, how the organizers should go, how workers should behave. That's it. I don't have any desire or ambition to occupy any position. Position is an imposition to me. I'm a free man. So, I'm not an obligation to anybody, but I'm prepared to spread the truth and work for dharma and live for Sai message. That's all. I've been telling everywhere, live for Sai as a devotee or else not. Live for Sai or else live not. Yes. Live for Sai. If we want to live for Sai, I should be ready to sacrifice. I should be ready to say, to tell the truth. I should be ready to correct. I should be ready to be corrected myself. I should be ready to direct, and I should be ready to be directed myself. It is not one-way traffic any longer. It is both the ways. I don't know what prompted me to go in this whimsical or fanciful ways as some would feel, but I am not able to silence my inner voice. I am not able to pacify my inner urge to work in this direction. All quarters are quite favorable. Results have been encouraging. That's why I could not be present for some of the earlier Sundays. So there was interruption in my series of Sunday's talks. Hope you will understand me. In the larger interests of people living elsewhere in far-off countries, far-off places in India, I thought I am just going over there and talking to them. 1 hour Sunday talk, if I just don't attend, please understand, it means 3 days of work for me there. Just 1 hour talk means 3 days of my work elsewhere, which I have been successfully doing. And I am sure that I could make myself clear what I really want, the task ahead of me. The topic for today is tasks now. These are the tasks of everybody, not merely Anil Kumar. Yes. Swami is important. Baba is our life. Baba is our breath. Anything, anyone, any time would come next, that's all. Come next. I don't mind if I am to be unpopular. You don't need to please everybody, goody, 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 everybody. He is to be suspected. If anyone is good to everybody, goody, goody, is something wrong with him. How can you be good to everybody? Impossible. Unless you are top to bottom selfish fellow. So we don't have to be like that. When it's a matter of truth, I should be able to say that. I'll give you a simple example. There are some people that quote Swami to their convenience. I know a person, let me not name him, he is a permanent resident here. He is a very rich man. Very rich man. Maybe that somebody asked him to donate or something like that. He was very much disturbed because he's rich and richer in being a miser. He's richer. Therefore, he came to me and said, "What, Anil Kumar, they are asking that and this. Sai Center asked me to contribute. Did not Baba say that God and money are not related? Did not Baba say that God has nothing to do with money?" I said, "Are a wonderful man you are. Good. Baba said it, I don't deny it. But same Baba said, Nakarmana na prajaya, dhanena chagena ike amurtato manasyuhu. No position, no authority, no fame, nothing takes you to liberation other than sacrifice." Other than, same Baba said. Then he has put a question mark face. Next day he met me. I was thinking of what Swami said. Why did he make these two contradictory statements? Why did he say God and money has got nothing to do with each other at one time? Another time, sacrifice only gives you salvation or liberation. Why? I told him, there is one book by name Indian Penal Code, law. One lawyer argues that I have not committed murder. A very innocent fellow. Mr. Anil Kumar is a child, he doesn't know anything. Same book. The other lawyer will prove that I am a murderer of class number one, and is not the only one, there are other people also who were successfully murdered by me. Same book. One lawyer says, I am guilty. The other, a criminal. The other lawyer says, I am a free man, never committed any mistake at all. Same book. So you should apply Swami's teachings to the situation, not to your convenience. This is going on by, used conveniently by opportunists, by political people. It is deceiving one's own self. You are not deceiving anybody. You are deceiving one's own self if you take Swami's teachings to your convenience. Then I explained to him. Swami said, God has nothing to do with money. This is said to those people who just think that they can buy God. I donate. I have given money. Come down. It's nothing to do. For you fellows who are rich people who don't take single rupee out of your account, chage naike amurtatva manasu, you sacrifice. Yes. And to that man he said, God has nothing to do with money, because don't calculate God in financial or monetary grounds or material way. Material is immaterial to God, is beyond. For this group, God has nothing, and then sacrifice. What does it mean? Sacrifice your ego, sacrifice your resources, sacrifice your time, sacrifice your money. Amurtatva manasyuhu. Then only you attain to liberation. That's what he meant. Therefore, we should take Swami's message, which is applicable to the time. Simple example. We give some fruits, Batavias, bananas, orange fruits, for distribution to patients in the hospital. Supposing you give bananas and orange fruits to a diabetic fellow, are you serving him? You want him to be transported to the other planet earlier. Your service is a visa to go to heaven directly. It's not service. You should give that which should be given to that man. Because I have fruits, come and take it. I brought some sweets today. Let me give it to those fellows. Therefore, my friends, we should use our discrimination. We should use our sense of judgment, discretion, because you are endowed with intellect, and conduct ourselves. So the task for now is to address ourselves to these four categories of people, of devotees whom I mentioned in the beginning. And the task now is to be broad-minded, to be universal, to be cosmic, and change our presentations to the public in general, reflecting Baba's message, and to expect some kind of transformation in our leadership, in our day-to-day routine, in order to rise to the occasion, in order to live to the expectation of Bhagwan Sri Sat Sai Baba. May Bhagwan help us in this sincere endeavor. May Baba bless each and every one of you with that spirit of zeal and enthusiasm, with that spirit of steadfastness and staunch faith, such that our minds would never waver, such that our minds would never give any scope for ego and jealousy, so that our Lord will feel proud of his devotees. Sai Ram. Thank you, everybody. I have got this, sir. I'll take it up next time.
Om Asato Ma Sadgamaya Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya Mrutyorma Amrutangamaya. Om Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu. Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu. Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Jai Bolo Bhagwan Sri Sat Sai Baba Ji Ki.
Jai
Bolo Bhagwan Sri Sat Sai Baba Ji Ki.
Jai
Bolo Bhagwan Sri Sat Sai Baba Ji Ki. Here you go. My friends, for your information, next week, which will be the 9th of December, I'll be in the state of Kerala. And then the 16th December, Sunday again, I'll be in the state of Rajasthan. And to 23rd December, I'll be in the state of Goa. See you next year. Sai Ram, thank you very much. Thank you.